Today's lecture is on blood exchange transfusion by Ms. Mandeep Kaur from Kanika's Nursing Academy.
Hi, my name is Mandeep Kaur, faculty from Kanika's Nursing Academy. Today we are going to discuss about the blood exchange transfusion in neonates. So what is blood exchange transfusion? Blood exchange transfusion is removing and replacing the aliquots of blood. So when we are talking about removing, we are removing the blood from the patient and we are replacing it with the donor's blood. So when we talk about the aliquots means small volumes. So why we need to do the blood exchange transfusion? So blood exchange transfusion is used when there is severe hyperbilirubinemia. So we can say when the other therapies like phototherapy or other medical therapies have failed and the serum bilirubin level is in increasing trend, which is not coming under the control. So in other cases, we can say we can use it in the case of chronic trials, in case of autoimmune disorders, isoimmunization, G6PD deficiency, and severe anemia, polycythemia, etc. So over here, how much amount we can exchange in a neonate or an infant? So there we have some blood volumes which can give us the estimates how much blood should be exchanged. In case of the term infant, we can give 80 ml per kg. So what is the weight of the baby? By that, we can get to know the volume to be exchanged. And in case of preterm, we take the volume 100 ml per kg. So when we talk about the types of blood exchange transfusion, we have three types, that is single volume exchange transfusion, double volume exchange transfusion, and partial exchange transfusion. So in single volume transfusion, we can do 1 into circulating volume. So as it is showing, single time blood is exchanged. So it means 1 into circulating volume. For example, we take a 3 kg of term infant. So in 3 kg of term infant, if we take 80 ml per kg, it will become 240 ml blood to be exchanged in an infant. In double volume exchange transfusion, we give 2 into circulating volume. So blood is exchanged 2 times. So for same example, if baby is 3 kg, the volume will be 480 ml. So third is the partial exchange. Partial exchange is done in case of the polycythemia, for which we have a formula in which we should know the actual hematocrit value of the baby. So if this actual hematocrit value is minus by the desired hematocrit value into the blood volume, that is ml per kg divided by the actual hematocrit volume. So in case of the single volume exchange, almost 65% blood is replaced, and in double volume exchange, almost 85% of blood is exchanged. So double volume exchange transfusion is the most common type of transfusion which is used in severe hyperbilirubinemia, and it is successful to reduce 50% of serum bilirubin level after the procedure. But there are chances of rebounding of serum bilirubin levels after 4 hours. So after the procedure, baby should be placed under the phototherapy. Now we will move on to the procedure, how this procedure is performed. For the performance of this procedure, the medical officer is required and a trained nursing officer is required for the procedure, which is performed under the sterile techniques. And the blood which should be exchanged of, should be a whole blood, which is collected freshly, not older more than 5 days. And the exchange of blood is done in small aliquots. Here we have the criteria how it is done. If the baby weight is less than 1500 grams, we will take 1 aliquot of 5 ml. If the weight is between 1500 to 2500 grams, we will take 10 ml. 2500 to 3500 grams, we will take 15 ml. And if above 3500 grams, we will take 20 ml for each aliquot. So before performing this procedure, we should take the vital signs of the baby. We should record all the other important information like the pre-procedure serum bilirubin levels, and then we should know the SpO2 of the baby. Other general condition of the baby should be maintained so that the during the procedure there should not be a problem. So while performing this procedure, we need the things like we need the umbilical vein catheter. There should be 2 3-way adapters. So to the 2 3-way adapters, we will attach a drainage bag to one port, and to the other port we will attach to the blood bag, and to the third port we will attach a syringe. So when we talk about the umbilical vein catheter, Umbilical vein catheter is inserted into the umbilical vein, which is approximately 7 cm in length inside the umbilical vein. So when we start the procedure, first of all, we will close the drainage bag port and blood bag port so that a direct opening is available to the umbilical vein. So small amount of blood is withdrawn first and we will open the drainage bag port and this blood is discarded. So we are collecting first blood from the baby which is discarded and after discarding the blood this port is closed. Now we will open the blood port and we will withdraw the blood from the donor blood and this blood will be given into the baby. So this procedure will take for one step it will take around 5 to 10 minutes and for the whole procedure it will take approximately 2 hours. So while doing this procedure we will check the vital signs of the baby every 15 minutes in which we should also check the blood pressure and SpO2 of the baby. So after completion of 100 ml of exchange transfusion, we should give 1 ml of calcium gluconate and after giving the calcium gluconate, we should flush it with the normal saline because we don't want to direct contact of calcium with the transfusion blood because it may cause the clotting over there. So before giving calcium gluconate and after giving calcium gluconate, we should flush the catheter line with the 0.9% normal saline. And there also we can give the fresh frozen plasma midway the procedure and after completion of the procedure. So that is around 10 ml per kg. So it will be given over 15 to 20 minutes. So after completion of this procedure, what we should take care? A proper blood exchange transfusion record should be assessed on which vital signs of the baby will be recorded and amount of blood which has been withdrawn and which has been given to the baby should be recorded so that there should be no discrepancy in the amount of blood withdrawn and amount of blood given to the baby. So after the procedure, as I have earlier told that, baby should be placed under the phototherapy. So baby's vital should be assessed properly and we should also keep watch on the serum bilirubin level post procedure which will be repeated after 6 hours of the procedure. So proper monitoring is required so after the procedure also to maintain the general condition of the baby. So this is all about the blood exchange transfusion. I hope it will be of help for you. Thank you.